In this problem, we're given a position time graph for some object, and I have grid units of meters on the position axis. So these numbers are a little bit small, but this is 1 meter here, 2 meters here, and 3, 4, and 5. And then I have units of seconds on the time axis. So this is 1 second, 2 seconds, 3, 4, and 5. In part A, I'm asked for the velocity at t equals 2 seconds. So it's this moment in time right here. Well, the instantaneous velocity at that moment in time is just the slope of the position graph at that moment. But this is a line segment, and that has a constant slope. So I can choose whatever method I want to measure the slope of this line segment, and I've got my answer. The best approach to this is to look for integer grid points, and then I simply compute rise over run. And the rise on that time interval, in other words, the change in position, is a +2 meters, +2 grid spaces, and the run is a +3 seconds. And so the slope of that line is 2 meters over 3 seconds, or 2/3 meters per second. Or if you want to state as a decimal to 3 sig figs, I could write 0.667 meters per second. In part B, we're asked for the average velocity from t equals 0 to t equals 5 seconds. And we recall that the average velocity is the slope of a line connecting 2 points on the position time graph. And so again, we just look at rise over run between these 2 points. And from my starting point to my finishing point here, I have a rise of -2 meters. This is a negative slope. And a run of +5 seconds. Sometimes we call that delta x for that change in position and a delta t for the change in time. And my average velocity can be written as delta x over delta t. And that's a -2 meters over 5 seconds. And I get -0.4 meters per second on average over that 5 second time interval. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.